Hello and welcome back to BeamNG.drive Monster Mayhem. Got a nice special video planned here for you. So, as you can see here, we've got the King Krunch truck. I've got a special camera angle here going around. It's a cinematic, and it's real nice. It's showing off all these different angles. So, like I said, for this video, we got something a bit special planned. You can probably see we're staged up here on the start line of a racetrack. And there's some crush cars in front of us. And we got some grandstands, bleachers, and whatnot over there where some fans and whatnot would be sitting normally. Let's switch to the normal camera angle here. So like I said, this is King Krunch. We got some crush cars set up over here. Bleachers and everything over there. This track should be familiar possibly to some of the older fans of the Monster Truck. Monster Truck racing shows. This track is Bloomsburg, Pennsylvania, and this would be the Bloomsburg Fairgrounds. Yes, Bloomsburg Fairgrounds. We also have another truck set up over here. We'll get to that in a moment. So this is, like I said, Bloomsburg, and it's set up in just a basic straight line drag racing course. And yes, so yeah, so yes, we have King Krunch here. The other truck over there is Barefoot. We also have several other trucks already prepared. You can kind of see them off in the background there. We will get to those in good time. But for right now, I'll just explain what we're doing here. This is a retro recreation, sort of. So I got a bunch of classic retro trucks, and I tried to find the closest versions of them that would have been closest to what they looked like in about 1991, which is what this is. So it's like a Bloomsburg 1991, the Penda Point series racing series. And so King Krunch, this is not what King Krunch looked like back then, but it's about as close as I can get to it. The Barefoot truck, however, is almost about dead perfect. It's got the right paint job. Obviously, the chassis is all new and everything, but and like I said, we've got more trucks. I'll go over those when we get to them. But for right now, we're just going to take some single shot racing. Just racing runs here. We're are already staged up here on the line. So let's go. So, you know, it may seem a little boring doing just these straight line drag courses, but I find them to be fun. There's a nice simplicity to the straight line drag courses and a little bit of strategy with the cars, because if you don't crush the cars down right, then you could get bad launches off of them. Don't crush them down right, you can get bad launches off of them. You can end up going crooked. Ooh boy, real crooked. Crunch up right about. Okay. You can see three of our other trucks over here. We've got the Outlaw, we've got No Problem, and we've got the Carolina Crusher. And we'll get to those in a moment. First, let me switch over to Barefoot if I can manage to figure out how. There we go. Okay, we got Barefoot here. And like I said, this one's pretty damn close to the way it would have looked in 91. The paint job is pretty much dead on. Back then, Barefoot was a blue Chevy. And I believe the chassis was mostly red, maybe. It's got the right paint job, designs and everything. Looks really nice though. We're ready to go here, so let's get her on down the line. The strange thing about Bloomsburg is they have this weird little go under there, and there's also some crowd noise, which is nice. We're gonna give Barefoot another run here.
right on the line.
Ooh, here's a good straight run.
Nice.
Pull up right over here. There's another little gate or little entryway over here. And over here, we can see some more trucks. Bigfoot, King Kong, and Taurus. And once again, we will get to those in a moment. Let me first switch on over to the Outlaw. That's Outlaw, isn't it? That's the Outlaw. Take a look here. This one is actually about period correct as well. Except it would have had a front engine configuration in my rear. But that's true about pretty much all of these. Whatever reason. I like the chrome in the grill there. It looks real shiny. Nice. Okay. Ooh, looks like we may need to line this up better. Ooh. Take a whack. Try something a little different for this run. Let's go for the cab. Oh, not a bad run. I've been practicing on this track. Ooh, shit. Oh, got real damn close there. All right. Now, let's see. No, not that one. There we go. Bigfoot. Bigfoot's even got some nifty flags. Now, Bigfoot, you'll notice right there, it's really, I don't know how to explain it. You can just see the way the chassis or the suspension leans. This truck has a very, unusual, suspension setup. And that's because in 91, it was running what it called a cantilever suspension. Which means in the back, you'll notice there's no shock towers like normally. It's because the shock towers, don't know if you can see my mouse cursor here, but the shocks actually connect to the back of the truck. They don't have the normal, like, up and down shocks, but they go from the back of the truck to... As a matter of fact, look. Let's see. Yeah, you can see the shocks are... Once again, I don't know if you can see the mouse cursor. I may not have... fixed it from last time, but these things here, actually, if I hit this button here, you can see these dots. That'll help illustrate the point, even if the mouse cursor is not working. These orange dots, or they turn orange as my mouse cursor goes over. These, and then over here as well, but these things here are actually the shocks. So instead of being the normal ones like you have in the front here, you can see the ones in the front. Instead of being the same ones in the back, they have these different ones that they always referred to as the cantilever shocks. And it makes the truck pitch kind of weird when it takes off, and it flies a little awkward too. But anyways, we're all set up here on the start line. Let's give it a shot. Ooh, and she power wheelies off the line. Take a second run. I'm gonna take a little bit of a different approach on this one. Just power wheeling it like I did off of the start, it's probably not the best way to do it. So what we're going to do this time, instead of launching it in drive, I'm going to launch from first gear and see if we can shift into second partway down the track. So let's go for it. Oh. She's still... Oh, boy. Didn't even hit it straight. Oh. Okay, so launching from first didn't really change anything. I'm not sure what this area over here is meant to be. All right, we're gonna move on to our next truck. Whoa. Get right up on the rear end there. And, is that no problem? Yep, that's the one. That's what we're looking for. Good old no problem. He's got kind of an interesting shock setup on this truck as well. So we're probably going to have weird run on this guy too. The old Ford Bronco body style there. Yeah, different kind of shocks. One in the back, maybe. One or two in the front. Yeah, two in the front. All right. Here we go. Not a bad run. That weird effect that you're probably seeing there, that's the windshield. These things have Lexan windshields, so it kind of has this weird effect. Looking through it there. All right. Nope, not quite him yet. There we go. We have King Kong, and it's labeled as King Kong 3. All right, and this one has a weird transmission setup. And his headers go up out the top. Yeah, he's got, like I said, an interesting shock setup. He's got the coilover shocks, one at all every corner. I forgot to take the driver out of him. This one does not have a drive gear in the transmission or park. Don't know why. You need to change. Power wheelie it. Really springy. This is the reason why I've never liked these coilover suspensions on trucks. Got a lot of chassis lean. The thing doesn't have any sway bars on it. Really leans over bad. One more time, let's take another run at it. Oof. Move on to the next truck we got here. Yes. The Carolina Crusher. This one also has an odd transmission setup, but the suspension is normal. Let's do this. That was a bit crooked of a run, but it still wasn't too bad. We'll give it another whack here. A little bit straighter of a run here. There we go. We got one last truck here. Oh, there it is. And this is Taurus. And this is very much a new version of the truck. Got these nice king shocks on it. DKTs on it. Very not period correct, but it all looks very nice. Really. Okay. Here we go. Definitely not a bad run. Here we go. Well, but anyways, I want to thank you all for watching once again, as always. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Bit of car crushing. The King of Krunch is going to show us how it's done. There we go. Let's see here. The Outlaw, sure. They really need to make it so each one of the trucks has its own little thing in the that menu there. Make it a lot easier to tell them apart so I can just do this. King Kong up next. That works. Really wonky suspension with these springs. Cars can get pretty mangled up. They can use doors and trunk lids. And... Uh-oh, we lose it. Is that a four-link or a tie rod bar? I don't know. Like I said, them cars can get pretty messed up, and they'll grab onto your freaking tires, too. Wow, the parking brake on this thing doesn't work for shit. Well, we'll just leave it right about there. Big old mess going on over here. Oh boy. The Crusher. Oh. Yeah, that happens every once in a while. These cars, they get torn up like this. Yeah, they're actually mounted to some weird frame thing down there that's supposed to hold on to them. It doesn't really do it the job after too long. Ouch. Oh boy, I lost both back wheels. Jeez. Truck we still got over here. Nope. There it is, Taurus. So that's going to be it, I think, for this video. So thank you all for watching. Join us next time for more Monster Mayhem. Thank you all, and good night.